There are a lot of goals you want to achieve and win in your career. Being champion jockey is a whole season. It's a whole year of riding winner after winner. You've got to have the talent. Not anyone can just decide, I want to be champion jockey and achieve it. And you can't only do well in one centre. You've got to do it across the country. And something can go wrong very quickly, and all of a sudden you're out of the race. So the ultimate, in my opinion, and I think most jockeys' minds, is to win the South African Jockeys Championship.
Six-time South African champion, Pierre Stradom. To take the championship, you must ride more winners in the season than any other jockey in South Africa. The season begins on the 1st of August and ends on the 31st of July the following year.
Every jockey out there would like to win the title, but it doesn't come easy. It takes a lot of work, a lot of money goes into it. Traveling all over the country, accommodation and hiring cars.
2014 contender Richard Free. In South Africa, there are race meetings every single day of the year, except Christmas Day. To chase the championship, it's a grueling year, riding between 5 to 7 days a week at racing centres across the country.
From being an apprentice, you see people that have been called top jockeys because they've earned it. It's all about being the best at what you do. And, for you to be the best, you have to prove yourself that out of all the 100+ jockeys that are here in South Africa, you know your thing and you can do better. And winning the championship, it's something as everyone wants to win.
This is the story of the 2013-14 National Jockey Championship and what it took for 28-year-old S'manga Khumalo to become the first black South African to take the title.
Your champion jockey, S'manga Bling Khumalo.
Tuesday, 1st of July 2014, a routine midweek race meeting at the Vaal Racecourse in Gauteng. With 8 weeks to go before the end of the 2014 season, S'manga Khumalo is 20 winners ahead of his nearest rival, Richard Faree. In third place lies last season's champion, Pierre Stradom, some 35 winners behind Khumalo. Taking the first race on the Philly Peep Show, it looks to be the start of another good day for jockey S'manga Khumalo.
Outside, but Peep Show is going to give Khumalo another winner.
But then from nowhere, fate steps in and everything changes. Her first time at the races past the post, the inexperienced filly Peep Show decides to head back to the stalls and ducks in sharply towards the rail. Suddenly aware of the barrier in her path, she swerves back and in the process throws S'manga off her back and onto the railing. Semi-conscious, stabilized, as he lies in the first aid room awaiting the ambulance to take him to hospital, with the championship within his grasp, and scheduled to ride in the prestigious Durban July Handicap the forthcoming Saturday, for S'manga Khumalo, suddenly, there's a lot hanging in the balance. A year earlier, on Saturday the 6th of July 2013, before a home crowd of some 60,000 people, S'manga Khumalo, the homeboy from Kwa-Mashu Township outside Durban, became the first black South African jockey ever to take the prestigious Durban July Handicap when he won the race on the gelding heavy metal. S'manga Khumalo,
having the season of a lifetime. Oh, it's a feeling I'll cherish for anything. It was my first July, and for me to win it out of all those guys, 50, 60,000 people cheering, and it just electrified me. I think for a whole week I was in that happy mood, and I'll never forget that day.
Ngikhanya ngoJuly handicap lo awuthatha ngonyaka odlule. Ngoba uyena umuntu owaqala ukuthi aphumelele omnyama ewujoki.
Ngikhela S'manga into eyangijabulisa kakhulu enkathi ewina uVodacom July ngo-2013. Ngingathi iyona-ke eyasenza sayithola sesijabule kakhulu. So umndeni lapho ngiyacabanga ukuthi kwayilapho eyashabalisa khona ukuthi hayi ingampela mpela mina ikusasa lami lila emahashini la sambona khona ukuthi hayi uJoki wakuzalwa ke lo.
At 16-1, heavy metal was considered by most to be an outside shot. But for S'manga and those loyal followers who listened to his pre-race comments on radio, he had duly delivered.
Looking at his prep, I thought I would be in the first lane. I would go out there and make everybody proud. But just 2 days before the race, I was invited to the radio stations to talk about the July. And so a lot of people listened and came to the course and they witnessed this thing, one of the prestigious races here in South Africa. It's a big event, and for me to win it and people that listened and that came through, it was something I'll never forget.
Kwalo busuku lami saphuma la endlini no-aunt wakhe noma wey'ngane zakhe sahamba saya emaracini ngezwa sekumenyezwa sekuthiwa kuwina uKhumalo seke ngendlela engajabula ngayo khona omunye osebenza khonaphana e-Graveyl wayengigijimisa engidlulisa sengijabula sengibonga.
Heavy Metal's connections were equally overjoyed. For trainer Sean Terry and owner Chris Fanica, having won the race the previous year with Pierre Stradom on Pomodoro, it was an incredible big race double. Well fancied to win the race again this year, Pomodoro failed to arrive, and owner Chris Fanica could hardly believe his eyes when Khumalo came through for the stable on the lesser fancied Heavy Metal.
Heavy Metal, the son of Silvano!
He was thrilled. He was ecstatic. He even gave me a hug, kissed me on my forehead. He said, well done, my boy. You know, I've always believed in you. And, you know, from those words coming out from his mouth and to see him that happy, even his other horse didn't come through, but the one that he expected, I was very happy. And I always say that when I ride for him, I'll do my best just to show him that, you know, he can always rely on me.
On a more somber note, at the time, South Africans were in deep reflection, as past president and father of the nation, Nelson Mandela, lay critically ill.
He's a great man. It's something special that ever happened for South Africa. And we were behind the pens, and we were told, no, they'll have a silent prayer for him. The whole cause just went silent, just to wish him well. I thought that was very nice. And if I could also have something to give, you know, it might not be much, but it's something from my heart. And when I won that race, I just had to dedicate this one to Tata Madiba, because, you know, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for him.
Inspired by his achievement in the July handicap, S'manga was on cloud nine. 2 weeks later at Turfontein Racecourse in Johannesburg, he rode five consecutive winners on the day.
I started having one winner, and the next one came, and I was like, oh, wow, you know.
Jet Fever's finishing fast on the outside, but our folly wins it from Jet Express.
The confidence is a boost now. I'm riding with a lot of confidence, and the third one came.
With Irish Gift trying to rattle back, but it is Isobar. Isobar, the winner, 1.5 lengths.
And the fourth one.
And could it be number four for this man today? Yes, it will be. Khumalo, yet again.
The fifth one was very tough, because the second horse, I thought he got me, and I just threw everything. I was like, I threw kitchen sinks there. And I got up a shot, it's a short head, and I was ecstatic.
Khumalo looking for number five on Up to the Moon. Up to the Moon, and S'manga Khumalo from Cats Game down the inside. Kamalo's gonna maybe just get there. Khumalo, five in a row, wins on Up to the Moon from Cats Game.
On that day, S'manga Khumalo gave reigning champion Pierre Stradom a few anxious moments as he came close to equaling Stradom's long-standing record of being the only jockey ever to win all six legs of the so-called Pick Six Exotic Bet in South Africa.
It's nice to hold records and break records. For me to have ridden six winners, which was all six legs of the Pick Six, is definitely something special because no one else has done it. My fiancée and the two kids, we were in Seychelles recuperating from the previous season and taking advantage of a holiday. And I was on the internet and we realized, well, S'manga had 5 legs of the pick 6 already. So it was like, wow, okay, I can't believe it. Someone's going to be able to equal this record that you are trying to hold for as long as possible. So obviously, you know, for him it's unlucky. But obviously for me, you know, it just meant I held the record a bit longer.
I know Mr. Stridham is a master and he's been in this game for a long time, and for him to achieve such and for me to be a little step behind or a step closer to him, I'm very happy. But, you know, on my side, I thought, like, people will always remember this day that S'manga Khumalo, after the July, he came to Tiffin and he did this wonderful thing. And for my people, it will be a best day to remember. It's something that they'll always cherish, and they'll be like, wow, we remember last year someone wrote 5 winners this day.
The next day, S'manga flew to Kenya, where riding at Ngong race meeting, he had another 4 winners. Making history at the Durban July Handicap, 5 consecutive winners at Turfontein, 4 the next day in Kenya, what a way to move into the start of the 2013-14 racing season. At the top of the log with a head start of some 14 winners in front of his nearest rival, newly crowned champion Pierre Stridham, it was time for S'manga Khumalo to think seriously about going for the championship.
He rode 27 winners around about there in the first month, another 20-odd in the second month. So after 2 months, he was 50, 60 winners, and there was no jockey competition in sight. And that really, over the long term, because the championship is won over 12 months, not 2 months, that boost really gave him a huge head start over the rest of the competition. There was no particular strategy. It was really get the best rides, as many as we can, let's go full tilt to try and break history and become the first black champion South African jockey.
Looking back at the July, you know, coming in my home turf, Turfontein, and the small crowd and how they clapped and screamed, like, you know, this is our champion, this is our champion. And from then, you know, I could never let them down. I have to carry on and ride and fulfill also my dream of winning the title. So, yes.
Chasing the title, jockey and agent are a mutually interdependent two-man team. While S'manga rides to bring home the winners, it's up to Justin to study form, contact the trainers, and get S'manga on the best rides available.
It differs from rider to rider. S'manga is someone who needs someone to do his rides completely. He is very, very busy when he's chasing the championship, and even when he's not, he's riding 4, 5, sometimes even 6 and 7 days a week. So he's always on planes, on the road, getting to the courses. And then not all jockeys are very good form studiers and know their form as well as their agents do per se. So they prefer to have someone who's a professional in that field and lets them handle getting them onto the right horses in the races so they can do what they're good at, which is deliver the horses to win races when they need to. He does give me feedback after each race meeting on how particular horses ran and horses he might think we want to stick with next time. And then when the weights come out, I deal with the trainers and try and get the best option in each race.
One of 5 siblings, S'manga Khumalo was born on the 29th of November 1985 and grew up in L Section, Kwa-Mashu Township, outside of Durban. This was the final decade of the apartheid era, and in 1990, after 27 years on Robben Island and in Victor Verster prison, Nelson Mandela was finally released from his incarceration. In the run-up to the first democratic elections from 1990 to 1994, black communities across the country experienced the most violent conflict in South Africa's history. Rural and township areas of Natal in particular were ravaged by violent conflict between the ANC and Inkatha, fueled by elements of the ruling regime and an insidious so-called third force, hell-bent on derailing the forthcoming transition to democracy. Thousands of innocent black civilians lost their lives. In the midst of this carnage, S'manga was a young boy attending primary school in Kwa-Mashu.
At that time, everybody knows from the 90s, it was pretty rough and there was a lot of fights, but we never knew what it was for. It was pretty rough, and a lot of people that were close to me I knew also passed on. And luckily, my mother, she moved me from Wamashu to stay with her sister at Inanda. I stayed there for another 5 years. And then when I finished primary, I had to go to high school. And that's when I went back again to Wamashu.
By 2001, some 7 years into the new democratic and political dispensation, the violence had abated, and S'manga returned to attend Umzavela High School in Kwa-Mashu.
And that's when I thought, you know, there wasn't much that I could do work-wise, because even my sister, she finished school before me and she's still sitting here without a job, because there's a lot of people that couldn't get opportunities to find jobs. So when I saw this opportunity, I took it with both hands and I said, you know, at least it's something I'm gonna do for my family, for what they did for me, to move me from the violence and the shooting to get a better education and a better life for myself.
True to his word, while still at the academy, S'manga became the family breadwinner and told his mother to give up her job as a domestic worker.
Just recently bought a house of her choice, and she always wanted to stay in Newlands. Told her this is hers, and thank you very much for helping me to get a better education and a better life. At least she has something also she can be proud of and be happy about, because where we were staying, it was from our grandparents' house, and you know, she never had her own house, so we are just like family all living together.
Mina uSimanga njengoba ngithengela nomuzi ngajabula kakhulu ngoba ngineyingane futhi ngangazi ukuthi ngiyokwazi ukuthi ngihlale neyingane zami ngijabule ngale ndlela ngaye eyedwa. Akaze angilahli nobusi sibakhe nobhuti bakhe. Bihleli ngaso sonke isikhathi engisengethe faka imali sithenga ukudla sonke isikhathi.
Even though he no longer lives there, now resident in Johannesburg, S'manga still regards Kwa-Mashu as his hometown.
I still consider it as my home. When I raised in Durban, I go to the old house where we used to stay, and sometimes I go stay with my mother. When I won the July, and after that I went to Kwa-Mashu, and the whole neighbors and all friends, they came to my house and to wish me a good luck to winning the July. They were so proud that a small township boy has made headlines like this, and they were over the moon. So yeah, I do consider it my home.
Like many champions before him, in 2001, at the age of 16, S'manga Khumalo started his career as a young apprentice at the South African Jockey Academy at Sommerfeld in KwaZulu-Natal. At the academy, whilst completing their formal education, apprentices from all over the country are trained in every aspect of horsemanship. Their day starts before dawn. Under the supervision of riding masters, before sunrise, they set out for the riding centers where they ride early morning work for the various racing stables. Back at the academy, after breakfast, they attend their formal education classes before spending the afternoon mucking out the stables and tending to horses.
We started going around the track at the academy just to get a feel for horse galloping, because it's a different feel from trotting and to canter. And me, I've never been on a horse before, and I was very tiny. I wasn't strong enough, and I couldn't hold them to resist them to do what I want them to do. They'll just get in the track and then just run as fast as they could. And, you know, that terrifies me, because I don't know how to stop them. I'll go maybe 5 times around the track, and when you come back, the guys will laugh at you, and because you're supposed to go once and quite nicely and slowly, you know. And so, yeah, there were some nice times, and school also. I used to ride horses and go to school. It was hectic, but it helps you to become a better horseman, and also to know all the bones of the horses and where the horses hurt. And that really helped me, because I never knew that could this animal get hurt, you know, because they're so big and strong. And finding out that they do have problems. And from then, you know, you become a better horseman, and you get to know them better. So all that helps you to become a better jockey and to do best at races.
By arrangement with the academy to further his experience, in 2003, S'manga went to Zimbabwe, where he rode for champion trainer Lisa Harris, as well as the powerful Kirk Swanson Yard.
My first winner was in Zimbabwe for Miss Harris in 2003, and the horse's name was Lightning Don. And Mrs. Harris was so pleased that she could give me my first winner. And I started riding for her. And she helped me to boost my confidence and also to boost my career. And from there, like, Kirk Swanson started to have a look and say, hey, wow, this guy can ride.
Back in South Africa, S'manga continued his apprenticeship at the Jockey Academy at Rankiesfontein in Gauteng. Under the skillful eye of Academy Master Rob Moore, S'manga completed his apprenticeship in 2006.
Mr. Moore helped me, because I was sitting too short and I was very high and, you know, on the saddle. So he said, I must just drop 2 holes and then I'll be perfect. And he also helped me a lot in teaching me the 3 most important things when we ride: balance, sit and grip. So I took that and carried on. So it's been a long journey, but it's been very nice. I've enjoyed every single bit of it.
Developing his riding style based on balance, seat and grip, on the 7th of November 2006, S'manga had his first big day, riding 5 winners at Kimberley. On the 4th of January 2008, S'manga again made his mark when he rode all 4 legs of the so-called jackpot exotic bet at Fairview Racecourse in the Eastern Cape.
Major share-up along the outside, but I can tell you it's a jackpot here for Mitch Visa and S'manga Khumalo.
In March 2011, S'manga rode his first Grade 1 winner when he took the Horse Chestnut Stakes at Turfontein on Dance with the Devil.
The last 200, and Dance with the Devil has won a fantastic race, has won a Grade 1 Dance with the Devil by 4 lengths.
A month later, on the 12th of April, S'manga took his second Grade 1, once again on Dance with the Devil, winning the Laurie Jaffe Empress Club Stakes.
You've got a champion, Dance with the Devil. She'll win it comfortably. She'll win it by 3 to 4 lengths from Well Witcher, second flirtation.
But then, riding the crest of the wave, 2 months later on the 25th of June, things took a turn for the worse when S'manga took a bad fall and broke his leg.
mangabe hambe ema racing ngoba uSimanga ukalimali kabi ngingaphathe kahle mina ngumzali wakhe.
Yeah, you never know when you're going to get hurt. You can get on a horse in a parade ring and get hurt on the way to the start, in a starting stall. It happens so quickly and you just hope that you come out of it unscathed.
Khona unyaka la kalimala khona aphuka imlenze. So sahamba no-Antoke sayegoli siyombona, sahlala nobhuti amajayivani, walulama saze sabuya.
I thought I could never get back on a horse because my leg was swelling up. There's no way that I could even walk. And with God's grace and with my family supporting me, and they gave me that boost all the time, you know, just to say, hey, don't worry, you're still gonna go back. And I'm like, nah, you know, I don't know what I'm gonna do though, because I never had any other qualifications or sports or something that I would go and do, you know, with my injury. So my family, especially my mother, she will always come here and look after me.
Mina njengomzali ngiphatheke kabi ngoba nosisi bakhe mangibatshele velelwa inkinga ke ngikhali endlini nokupheka ngabusapheka kahle ngendlela ngingakhululeki kahle ngingalali naye athi akafuni ukuthi ngizwe ukuthi khona into emvelele ngoba uya ngazi ukuthi nginenhliziyo enjani.
Even then, as now with his most recent fall at the Vaal, close by Samanga's side in the first aid room is Amanda Habib. Amanda is married to retired jockey Donovan Habib. As a family, they have experienced more pain and suffering through injury than most.
Amanda, we call her Ma at the jockey room there. She cooks for us and helps us to have nice meals and nice cool drinks, you know. Donovan, he also broke his leg. And he went through things like this. If any jockey gets hurt, she will go there in a medical room and ask you, where are you sore? What do you feel, you know? And then she knows because it's things that she's been through when her husband had the injuries. So she's been very big help and we could never ask for a better mom.
When Donovan had a fall at the Vaal and I was at home alone and I heard he had fallen, but we couldn't see what was happening and I was worried out of my mind about Donovan. And somebody there, a friend, picked up the phone and phoned me and said, I'm with your husband, speak to him. And the relief of having someone telling me that my husband was okay, from that day I said, if I'm by those jockeys, I will go each and every one of them so that I can phone their families to tell them that they're okay. So, you know, it just gives them a little bit of comfort as well, having a friend next to them at that time. Well, Donovan's had two serious injuries. The first one, he had to have a hip replacement, then he went back. And then after that, he was riding and he fell at the Vaal where he hit a concrete upright and he shattered his knee in 7 places. And the doctors also said to him that he didn't think he'd be able to ride again because he wouldn't be able to bend his knee. But Donovan never gave up, and after a year, he went back to riding, and then he rode for at least 4 years. But then obviously the knee wasn't holding up too well, so he had to be medically boarded thereafter.
It's very difficult to know that I can never ride again. In dreams at night, I dream I'm riding in a race, but I never get to the finish. It's amazing. It's a horrible feeling to know that your career has ended at such a short period. But life goes on.
7 months after breaking his leg, in December 2011, S'manga took another fall and badly injured his knee. Months later, back in the saddle, he fell again at the Vaal and broke his hand. By now, his injuries were getting to him. Despondent and demoralized, at an all-time low, S'manga was seriously considering throwing in the towel.
And they took him through to the Vereeniging and Medical Clinic, which is not far from my house. So he phoned me to ask me if I would fetch him. Coming back, yeah, he said he didn't feel like sitting the whole day at the races, you know, he's still injured and everything. Would I mind if he stayed with my husband at the house? And they just got speaking about all his problems that he's got, and my husband and him had a long conversation about his career.
And I was also like, I can't do this anymore, you know, like you might as well do something else on the side.
I do believe everything works in God's hands. S'manga and myself, there would never have been a day that me and him could actually sit down for a whole day and talk together. And then I could see in his heart he was scared to ride. He did not want to go on anymore. He had too many injuries too quick in a row. And you know, as a jockey, you think
It's fate. Something's against you. The badness is always against you. But you decide, I've had enough of this. Your mind tells you no more. And I said to him, look, S'manga, what's happened to me in my career? I've got a hip replacement, knee replacement. I've broken more bones than I think a lot of jockeys have. But I still get back on that horse and I go for it. But I'm telling you as a friend, if you're not going to get back on that horse and give your fullest and your best without being scared, forget about falls. If the fall comes, it's going to come. And if it does come, the next meeting you ride, bad luck. But I'm telling you, if you just have faith and go on with it, things will turn for you. I believe you're one of the top riders that I've ever seen. I'm going to take a lot of credit off to S'manga himself. He done it. He took his mind and he went out there and he done it himself.
Taking Donovan's words to heart and putting his fear behind him, on the comeback trail, S'manga began picking off the big ones. On the 1st of December 2012, he took Gauteng's premier event, the Sansui Summer Cup, on Wagner.
Wagner's going all the way in the Sansui Summer Cup, and Wagner's pulled it off! He's won the Sansui Summer Cup!
The key moment and the swing in the momentum of our relationship and S'manga's general career would be probably the Summer Cup victory on the horse Wagner for the trainer Joey Soma. He rode a particularly fantastic race from the front on that horse and obviously registered the Group 1 win, gained a lot of respect around the racing community, and that really thrust him into the spotlight and took him from becoming one of the jockeys just off the top to one of the top jockeys, which allowed us then to upgrade his selection of horses that he was riding in races, and along with that came numerous more winners and group successes.
I didn't at one stage want to watch racing anymore because it really hurt me to put on a TV and watch the racing. And after when I spoke with S'manga, we actually were sitting next to each other that day, I said to him, from here I'm going to watch you and I'm going to see if you've listened and you're going to go and prove yourself to me. And you know what, he's done it full out. And since then I've actually started watching racing again, got more into it, and I'm starting to enjoy it again.
On the 27th of April 2013, S'manga took the President's Champion Challenge on Heavy Metal.
Side and Heavy Metal has picked it up in the closing stages to win the President's Champions Challenge. It's Heavy Metal the winner.
And on the 6th of July 2013, taking the country's big one, not only did S'manga become the first black jockey to win the Durban July Handicap, but he also became the first jockey ever in South Africa to ride a grand slam of 3 out of 4 of the country's biggest racing events in one season.
Nickname Bling, ladies and gentlemen, S'manga Khumalo.
And in November 2013, S'manga was accorded his greatest honor yet when he was chosen as a member of the national team to represent South Africa in the International Jockeys Challenge.
It would probably be on a personal level the biggest challenges that he overcame and the ones that I'm most proud of him for doing, because to become a champion, it's a completely different thing from being a middle of the road jockey, a top 10, 15 jockey that he was. And becoming a champion, he had to make some big mind shifts and personal changes just about his attitude and his professionalism. And it's not easy for a young guy who had success thrust upon him so early and so quickly as he did. And he made a lot of changes to the way he carries himself and his professionalism as a whole. And that enabled him to now become one of the top jockeys of the country that he is.
The role of the National Horse Racing Authority is to ensure and promote the integrity of horse racing in South Africa to the highest international standards. And as an absolute and unquestioned priority for the racing fraternity, to protect and ensure the safety and welfare of the horse.
Can I say something?
Well, horse racing is one of, if not probably the cleanest sport in the world. We have the most stringent testing methods. Recently, I was intimately involved in restructuring the guidelines and the protocols to be used in respect of prohibitive substances and respective penalties. And in that regard, we now are the leaders in the world as far as that is concerned.
The team of men and women who police every race meeting across the country to ensure the attainment of these stringent priorities are the stipendary stewards and the course veterinarians.
Super tuned.
On the 5th of November 2013, 3 months into the 2013-14 season, S'manga Khumalo was cited for his riding of the first-timer Supertube in the 10th race at Davao, where he was charged with failing to take all reasonable and permissible measures to ensure that his horse was given a full opportunity to win or obtain the best possible placing. At the inquiry, the NHA handed S'manga a 60-day suspension.
S'manga would have had no chance of winning the championship if he served his 60-day suspension. You just can't give away 2 months and think you're going to win it.
Yeah, 60 days would have set me way back. I've been off for, I think, 30 days when I hurt myself previous season, and it did set me way back, and that's just 30 days. So 60 days, I don't think I would have been crowned the first SA black champion, but I'm glad I had Mr. Bloomberg by my side. When he had a look at my incident, he said, you know, S'manga, these things happen. The horse was a first-timer, and it's very hard that they could charge you on that ride. And, you know, consider on that day, I had 3 winners, 2 seconds and a third. The horse stumbles, obviously. My experience, I have to look after the horse, and the horse will look after me.
As far as S'manga is concerned, he appeared at the inquiry himself. He honestly believed that he had done nothing wrong and that he was just going to get a warning. And when he got the 2-month suspension, that's when he called me and he asked me if I would act for him. If you look at the facts in the matter, here you have a guy whose dream is to win the South African Championship. He's riding wherever he can, as often as he can. At the time of the appeal, he'd had 123 rides more than the next guy, Muzi Yeni, and 238 rides more than the third guy, Francie Herald. There was no evidence whatsoever about any underhand or illegal tactics employed. So you have to ask yourself, why would a jockey chasing the championship unilaterally and suddenly, for no rhyme or reason, decide to pull up a horse? I felt that at worst, it was an error of judgment because of the cards that were dealt to him in that Supertube stumbled shortly after the start and then nodded a second time. Those were the cards that were dealt to him, and he then had to make a judgment call.
In my opinion, your riding horse is a first-timer. They are green. They don't know what it's all about. In this situation, the horse comes out a little bit sluggish, a little bit slow. Stumbles after 2-3 strides. Normally at that stage you would think, oh, you know, there's something wrong here, but the horse stumbles again. So he stumbles twice, and the rest of the field who has gone a good speed already, they've already gone 4-5 inches clear in a matter of strides. Obviously, you now as a jockey, you've got to now make up your mind, is there something wrong with this horse or not? And by that time you've gone halfway through the race. And you've got so much ground to make up that you obviously now will just push the horse along, encouraging the horse to start running on and hopefully finish the race a sound horse and better from the first run, where obviously he's going to learn from it. So my opinion, in the back of your mind, you've got to think, this horse is a first-timer, he stumbled twice at the pens, and you've got to look after this horse for the future.
On the 14th of March 2014, attorney Robert Bloomberg represented S'manga Khumalo at the appeal. To their horror and utter dismay, the outcome was anything but favorable and posed the greatest challenge to S'manga's bid for the national championship thus far. The appeal was dismissed and S'manga Khumalo's deposit forfeited.
I've never seen a man so devastated when we walked out of the appeal. I must say that my ego was a bit dented that I'd lost the case on his behalf. But more so, I felt completely gutted for him. He said to me, you've got to get me to the end of the season. What am I going to do? My heart, my life, my desire, everything has been on my winning the championship. I worked so hard, they've stolen it away from me.
At this stage, with 4.5 months to go to the end of the season, S'manga, with a tally of 113 winners, was 22 ahead of his nearest rival, Piers Stradom. To delay the 60-day suspension, attorney Robert Bloomberg immediately notified the NHA of his intention to take the matter on review to the High Court of Gauteng. In so doing, he successfully achieved a stay in the suspension, enabling S'manga to keep riding through to the end of the season. Supertube, eventually piloted by Pierre Stradom, finally won his first race at the fourth time of asking.
I found that he was still quite a leggy horse and he just needed time to find himself, and it confirmed my thoughts even more so.
And so, back to the race for the 2013-14 National Jockey Championship, where halfway through the season, it looked as though Pierre Stradom might give S'manga a run for his money.
I had a slight injury. I fell at the starting stalls and I hurt my knee, which has given me trouble for quite a while. And a couple of weeks later, I hurt the same knee again. It was a setback where I had the momentum and all of a sudden there's no more momentum.
With Pierre out of the race and 3 months to go to the end of the season, a new challenger in the form of jockey Richard Faree began to loom large in S'manga's rearview mirror.
I thought Richard Faree would make a race of it. He'd come back from Hong Kong and you can see his riding had improved a lot. And he had quite a nice stable in the Snaith yard, and obviously rated P quite a lot.
I had 2 months to go and only had 17 winners to make up. I was riding the crest of the wave. I was riding winner after winner. It was right for inform stable as well. You know, so there was a lot of confidence going into it, and you know, it was just like two winners a meeting, sometimes three. Yeah, I was catching up at a good rate.
Onto the track. And then on Saturday, the 7th of June at Clarewood Racecourse, fate once again stepped in.
Oh, well, unfortunate accident 3 weeks ago. I did my AC joint in a Group 1 race, the Gold Challenge on board Jet Explorer, where another jockey unfortunately pulled in front of me and I forced my horse to clip heels and we came down. And, you know, that was just the showstopper for me. It would have been nicer going to the end, you know, maybe not winning it, but, you know, shortening the margin of the victory. But, you know, these small things unfortunately happen. So nothing away from S'manga. He did enough in the beginning to hold his own. You know, great respect to S'manga.
But it looked like S'manga just had that edge all the time and he was riding winner after winner. And even though Richard Faree closed the gap, I think down to 17, he got injured. And as I've said before, you can't get injured, you got to have a run. And obviously that stopped his chances of winning.
For S'manga, recovering from his fall on Peep Show at the Val, the news is both good and bad. On the good side, he has suffered no serious or permanent injury.
It was my right femur. It was quite bruised. And I had also a lot of pain on my head. They said it was a mild concussion. That news, it was great for me because there was no fracture and no broken bones to keep me off racing for a long time, you know. So I was pleased with those results, even though I was still in a lot of pain.
On the downside, the fall has put S'manga, last year's winner, out of the race for Saturday's forthcoming Durban July handicap. Richard Faree, on the other hand, recovering from his fall, has had time to focus on healing and being back in the saddle for the big event.
Obviously, when you fall off, you get a little bit furious and things take their own time to heal. But Jono Snaith, he's gotten involved. He managed to get me good treatment from Dr. Joe Debye, which is the best shoulder doctor out there. So I've gone to the best. They've done what they could do for me. And, you know, it's going stronger and stronger and there's not more that they can do now.
In his favor, on Saturday, Richard rides the well-fancied Legislate.
But I'm strong going into this race 100% and I'm very confident.
Legislate now alongside Wiley Hall. Legislate, Futurus flying on the inside. Here it comes, Wiley Hall perhaps ahead.
Winning an objection against Wiley Hall for critical interference with his mount Legislate, for Richard Faree, out of the running for the Jockey Championship, due compensation in defeat with his winning of the 2014 Durban July Handicap.
First winner back since fall at the start of the month.
For our champion in the making, just 2 weeks after his fall at the Val, Back in the saddle, S'manga adds two more to his tally at Turfontein, eventually taking his final total for the season to 185. 42 winners ahead of his nearest rival, Richard Faree.
Richard Faree imposed himself in the final months as a bit of a challenger, and then we had to up our game, and Richard unfortunately got a small injury there which kept him out. But as I say, you know, the championship is won over 12 months and not two. So S'manga was a deserved winner that year, and it was from my side. I wasn't doing the riding on the horse, but a lot of pressure trying to get onto the best rides, and obviously the pressure from S'manga to deliver winning rides for him to win on. So a lot of pressure, and about 2 or 3 weeks before, I think it became clear that he was going to win the championship, and it was like a massive relief off our shoulders.
I'm quite ahead, and I'm pretty happy, and also the guy that's second, he just won the Durban Work on July, and he seemed to be happy, and I think we're the two happy chaps, you know, at the moment.
For S'manga, it's been a long, hard ride, overcoming one challenge after another, picking himself up to come back after every fall. S'manga Khumalo has shown that he truly has what it takes to be a champion. At the prestigious Equus Awards, S'manga Khumalo is crowned the national champion jockey for the 2013-14 season.
It goes
on to the history books, not just the jockey title of SA, but it goes down on the history books of me being the first black jockey to win it. And I also think for my fellow black riders, they'll also know that S'manga has done it, so it can be done with a lot of hard work and dedication.
With the championship under his belt as South Africa's champion jockey for the 2013-14 season, S'manga Khumalo, the homeboy from Kwa-Mashu Township outside of Durban, was invited to the UK to ride at Ascot as a member of the rest of the world team in the prestigious International Shergar Cup.
It was his first trip to the UK. We got straight off the plane and into the heart of London, into Chinatown to do press conferences. So that was quite an eye-opener for S'manga. And he was well received by the press. Obviously, he's something very different. A black guy from South Africa arriving there with blonde hair and earrings. It was quite a shock for them. But, you know, there were some great jockeys in that press room and they all wanted a piece of S'manga. So it was a good trip and he really enjoyed it and gained some very good exposure from it.
In November 2014, ending off the greatest year of his career thus far, S'manga was accorded his greatest honor yet when he was chosen to captain the South African national team in the International Jockeys Challenge.
The captain this year is the South African champion jockey, Bling Khumalo.
Being a local guy from Kwa-Mashu and KZN, to be selected to be captain of your country, obviously on the back of being the first black champion jockey of South Africa, it was a big honor for him. We had some fantastic riders in our South African team, and obviously the team that came from abroad, great riders. You know, it was a very good competition over the days that it ran, and a fantastic honor for S'manga. In my opinion, the world is at his feet, because he's someone who I believe can fight it out with the best on the international scenes. He's reached the ceiling, in my opinion, in South Africa, where he's reached the championship. Now he can only win it a second or third time, but someone like him should be looking to go to Hong Kong, which he is looking to do, but it's all about taking the opportunity at the right time. Everything is about timing in this game. Now it's about getting the right opportunity to go to Hong Kong and prove himself with the best in the world, make himself, you know, very good money there financially that can set him up for the rest of his life, because obviously being a jockey, like any other sportsman, the time span of your career is limited. But as an athlete, a competitive athlete, you want to be competing against the best in the world. And S'manga is a great, great rider. And I think, you know, he deserves to show the world his talents in some of the biggest races and the biggest racing jurisdictions such as Hong Kong.